Viewers, this is Sensei Michael from Screen Review, bringing you a new podcast for a segment called The Boruto Review. And like always, I'm going to speak very loudly, very clearly, and very slowly, in case you don't understand me. Also, I'll try to do my best not to breathe a heart during this audio podcast recording as well, not to cause any audio feedback as well. And finally, if you're under 18, this audio podcast recording will change your adult language. Once again, If you're under 18, this audio podcast recording will attain your adult language. If you're over 18, that means you're going to watch this audio podcast recording. So anyway, let's get into the latest episode of Bork. Oh, sorry. I got something to my teeth. Anyway, it's gone now. Anyway, let's get into this latest episode of Bork, episode 96. So basically, this episode starts off at the mission office that is located in the Kage office building. So basically, Michi Nende, Nanade at the mission office waiting for her teammates, and that's when Boruto and his teammates saw Nanade so basically Boruto was talking to Nanade about this gang of thieves who've been stealing, treasures lately around the Hidden Leaf area and whatnot. So anyway, Sawada and Wasabi showed up, but during the mission, none of them used her sound juice on some bad guys. But unfortunately for Wasabi and Shredda, they didn't cover their ears, so basically they're temporary deaf. So basically they couldn't hear what Boruto and the others were saying to them. So Nanade was kind of upset that she made her teammates do temporary deaf. So basically she swore not to use her private sound technique ever again and cannot work on any new jutsu. So basically, the next day, I believe that Hanafa and her teammates were at the Hugo House where Nanade was debuting her new jutsu. So, jutsu is so Hanafa Sensei. So, basically, Hanafa Sensei, Chiwada and Wasabi watch Hanafa debut her new jutsu. Nanade can use water style jutsu. So basically she can shoot water for her mouth. But that would be her new jutsu style. Instead of shooting sound waves to my mouth, now she can shoot water for her mouth. But Hanafa Sensei told Nanade that your jutsu is a good idea, but you just lack control, or you need to work on your chakra control and your stamina to make your jutsu more effective. So basically, you know, Hannibal pushed Nanae to focus on chopper control and, you know, to match her, you know, to match her new water jutsu that she could shoot water from her mouth and shit. So basically the whole day, you know, Hanuma Sensei was helping Nanae to work on her new jutsu. So basically, while Wasabi and Shirata watch from the shoreline. So basically, by the day ended, you know, Hanover had made some profits with her new jutsu. So basically, but she still has a long way to go. So basically, Shirata and Wasabi, like, you know what, was this promise not made that they will work together, work with Nanae to, you know, with her training to match her new jutsu, Shirata and Wasabi promised to help Nanae to match her new jutsu tomorrow. So basically, the next day, you know, we see Hanuma and Wasabi, you know, helping Nanae match her new water jutsu along with Hanuma Sensei. So basically after some days of training, she finally got her new water jutsu mastered after a few days of training. So basically during the next mission, turned out they're supposed to escort some battlefield churches somewhere. So basically, Hanuma's team was supposed to escort some battlefield treasures to a location. Turns out, among these battlefield treasures was a scroll written by the first Hokage. Among these churches, they were escorting was a scroll written by the first Hokage of the Leaf Eater. So basically, the people who were escorting these churches needed an escort because of the thieves who've been stealing churches around the Hidden Leaf, around the area of the Hidden Leaf Village lately. So basically, you know, Hanuma's team was to make sure that the people who were escorting these churches don't get robbed by those thieves. So the mission was going fine until the beach showed up and tried to steal the treasures. So basically, Nanae used her new water jutsu, but turns out her water jutsu was not effective on the bad guys because they were using water clone jutsu. So basically, her new water style technique didn't work against the bad guys because the bad guys were using water clones. So therefore, her water technique didn't work against bad guys because they were using water clones. So basically, Shirata and the others were forced to go to hand-to-hand combat. And that's when Shirata summoned the ninja. And all of a sudden, the ninja went to a start to grow. So basically, the Nimba that she wanted this to summon went to a small size like a squirrel into a giant size as a dog. So basically, so turns out that the training that Chiwetel did with Nanane, help her change the size of the Nimbe. So basically now, so Chiwetel can change the size of the Nimba from a small squirrel into a giant dog of a size of a dog. Like Ikamaru. So basically, all that training with Nanane helped Chiwetel, change the size of the Nimba, now the Nimba can be big as a dog like Ikamaru. So basically, the training that Chiwetel did with Nimba, gave her the ability to change the size of the Nimba. So basically, the Nimba was the size of a squirrel. Now it can grow the size of a dog like Ikamaru. So anyway, the bad guys managed to get away, with all the treasures and whatnot. So basically, Hannibal told the girl to stay with the escorters while she go chase them down. So basically, turns out one of the escorters managed to keep the scroll from being stolen by the bad guys. So basically, the scroll that was written by the first Hokage was not stolen. One of the people who was carrying the skull, had it in his pocket this whole time while the bad guys were stealing the rest of the treasure. So basically, none of the others was happy that the bad guys didn't steal the skull, and that's when the bad guys, it turns out the bad guys were still there and listen to the whole conversation, and they figured that the skull will not be a part of the rest of the treasure. So basically, turns out the bad guys wanted the skull because a lot of people will pay a lot of money for it. So basically, they were talking was to get the scroll of the first Hokage. So basically, the bad guys managed to track Chiwetel, Sarada, and Wasabi into quicksand, use a quicksand jutsu to capture Sarabi, Chiwetel, and Nanara, and the rest of the escort party, so that way they can get the scroll. So basically, both of the thieves got the scroll from one of the escort persons. So basically, the bad guy was like, the boss was got themselves. So basically, the boss was getting away with the scroll, and Wasabi and Chiwetel was asked to tell Hannibal, to use her Kaido jutsu to stop her, but she was refusing because she refused not to use her Kaido jutsu because she's afraid that if she used the jutsu, they might end up temporary death again. But after at the Wasabi Inn is to run a game. Nanami worked her encouragement. She decided to use her quite than usual, and turns out all the training that she went through, controlling her, mastering her new water juice, help her control her sour juice even better. So therefore, she's able to focus her sound attacks more accurate now, therefore into one shot. So basically, she all the training that she did to master her new water style jutsu help her define her channel her sound jutsu better, therefore not letting anybody temporarily death. So basically, she hit the bad guy with a concentrated focused sound wave that took down the thesis boss, and therefore saving the squirrel. So basically, what a powerful focused sound wave, not only meant to take down the boss of the thieves, but the thieves were, and therefore nobody was told that, and they managed to get free from the quicksand juice as well. So basically, that's what's going to summon the Nimba back to help to take down the rest of the bad guys. So basically, that's the Hanaba Sensei who decided to come back after the Nimba was re-summoned back by Shredder. So basically, Hanaba Sensei was making her way back to the others. But, Nanaba once again was trying to use her new focus sound used to against the bad guys, but she lost focus and basically, instead of a focus stream of sound, she lost focus and let up a ultrasonic wave that knocked out everybody and leaving everybody temporarily dead. So basically, Hanaba's, I still need some work. So basically, Nanaba said that I still need some work on my sound technique. And when Hanaba showed up, she's like, I agree. So basically, later that day, when they went back to the Hokage, when they went back to the mission office, or I was called the Hokage office, Boruto and the others heard about everything. Heard how you took the how Nanaba took down the bad guys who was trying to steal the first Hokage scroll and shit like that. So basically, Boruto and the others was getting Nanaba popped for taking down the bad guys who tried to steal the scroll of the first Hokage and shit like that. So basically, Boruto was like, I thought you was not gonna use your sound, your carbon sound technique anymore. But after all the training I did, after a bit more training, I can finally focus. I don't have to worry about my sound technique leaving my teammates death anymore after all the training I did. So basically, after all the training that she did, she could finally focus her sound technique that won't, she could finally master her sound technique with the training she did, therefore not leaving her teammates told not me and her teammates death again. But, you know, but they were death after she lost focus on, but you know, Shimada and Masami were tone deaf after she lost focus. So basically, so the episode ended with, you know, with Boruto and others trying to talk with Shimada and, I mean, with Shimada and Masami, who are temporary deaf because of Hanuma losing focus of her new focus sound YouTube technique and shit like that. So anyway, but that episode ended with a confident confident that, you know, that she found a way to master her sound, her carbon sound YouTube and shit like that. So anyway, so this is how the episode ended, when Nanda, you know, smiling with confidence that she found a way to master her carbon sound YouTube and shit. This is how the episode ended. So anyway, this episode was not bad. This was a good character development episode for Nanade. So basically, Nanade, this was a good episode for Nanade. So basically, for her character, this was a good character development episode for Nanade. So basically, this episode was not bad. So anyway, what do you guys think about this episode? Was it good? Was it bad? Or was it just... Nah, please let me know with the comments below. Anyway, last order, this is Century Michael from Screen Review, signing off. 1.